the idea for Quest 1224 was born out of the fact that we've been growing up with Quest for the last, 10 years now, nearly at this stage. They started on this journey with us, and we want to push the boundaries for the event and push the boundaries of our participants now at this stage.
So I've done a lot of like the other Quest events, Quest Killarney, Quest Ackle, Quest Glendalough, and these events take normally between 3 and 5 hours to complete. So this is really a step up in terms of time. I wanted to do something that was longer and to see if I can finish the course under 24 hours.
We're going in at the deep end here. So the only kind of event similar was a try we did maybe a year ago. And so we're going in at the deep end here.
Yeah, I think actually getting there without getting lost is a big part, beyond of course the sheer size of the challenge.
So you got your GPS on for your little tracker?
Yeah, they'll be able to find me.
I think knowing some of the challenges that are ahead, the climbs that are ahead, whether it be on the bike or on the run and the hike, I think knowing that is a big advantage.
Hopefully in less than 24 hours time.
So we wanted to create an event that would be a different level of challenge for our participants, and beyond what we've kind of done before for them. It would be a step up for normal participants who'd be used to kind of our shorter events, but it also could attract new participants, new people, those who are focused on long distance, more endurance type races. The event is a celebration of our country. It's a celebration of Kerry, and South Kerry in particular, of the beautiful landscape, the sheer challenge, and everything that South Kerry and Carrantool and the McGillicuddy Reeks really hold.
The first cycle was tough enough, but I think once I get to the 3 o'clock cutoff, I'll be happy enough. And then do as much of the kayak as possible and walk the run, you know, the run.
We were really fortunate with the weather. It was a cracking day. There wasn't a breath of wind. It was perfect conditions for racing.
How are you getting on?
Absolutely horrendous.
Did some training days in the lead up to the event, but truthfully, you know, nothing can fully prepare you for an event of this scale. A lot of people followed our training plans, the nutritional blogs, and it worked out really well for them.
Hills.
It was really great to see the range of people who took part in the event. On one side of things, you had people doing their very first adventure race to raise money for charity. You had professional triathletes doing it. We had Quest regulars just trying to make that step up. And people who take part in Ironman who just wanted something different, something new, something a bit more adventurous. Some people said the kayak was the hardest part of the day. In fact, it was where the race was kind of won or lost for many people. I think a lot of people that are coming back next year are going to be training a hell of a lot harder on the kayak and getting the time in on the lakes.
The Devis ladder killed me already.
We're moving, we're okay.
First cycle was good enough, easy, mountain was okay. Second cycle was very tough. And the kayak was brutal.
We only have a 14k cycle and 20k run.
Fucking here. I would have took this morning, that's the truth.
Well, my body is very painful, it's very enjoyable. It's a great day, weather was savage. Go on, Quest.
I sort of controlled myself all day and kind of fighting the urge to floor it. So I deserved a bit in the tank, so hopefully. And you're not to get me over this time, you know?
Let's stop now. One leg behind.
Is it over?
Alright. I'm hoping I get through the race by putting a plaster on this blister.
It's
started to welcome people home to the Sneem Hotel mid-afternoon at the finish line, and they were still crossing the line 12 hours later. It was quite a shift for us to put in, but nothing like the shift that everyone put up in the mountains. It's an amazing day.
Crossing the finish line was the best feeling, you know, running up here, there's really good crowds, it was an amazing buzz.
But definitely train for it, you definitely have to train for it. No matter how small the event it is, no matter how fit you may think you are, they are an adventure race, you know, they're not a 5k park run, you really got to prepare for it.
It's great that we have such a good community of people that do our events. I think that culture and atmosphere is evident throughout the events. After the event, we spoke to participants, we did a survey, and the feedback was just so positive. The teamwork in here worked so hard on it, it was such a joy to see so many people embrace the challenge of it.